All right, let's get back to what happened with the Lakers and Warriors preseason debut on Saturday night. LeBron was plus 14 in 17 minutes of game action, and AD was plus 13 in 18 minutes. Lakers fans aren't the only ones who left Chase Center impressed by the Bron-AD combo. Take a look at what D'Angelo Russell told our Nick Friedell. Here's the tweet from Nick. It's different. It's different seeing all those big guys on the floor at the same time. LeBron playing point alongside those dudes. It's cool. It looks like a fantasy team or something. Is D'Angelo calling Bron and AD a fantasy team, BS or real talk? I'm going to go real talk right there.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Go ahead, Janae.
I'm not going to lie. I was looking. I know you're not supposed to look at the numbers for preseason games, but I was looking at the numbers, and it's kind of scary. I'm not going to lie, because AD with 22 points, JaVale and AD combined for 23 rebounds. And then on top of it, Dwight comes in and gives you 9 and 9. And then we're not even talking about LeBron James. LeBron James giving you 15 and 8 assists. I mean, yeah. Only 3 rebounds, but I mean, it's not.
It don't matter.
Preseason.
He needs to be there.
Thank
okay.
you.
So listen, that was not a preseason game. That was the Lakers who had spent 4 months having everybody take shots at them, trying to keep their mouths shut, trying not to say anything. And you heard LeBron at media day say, like, I'm somebody who's not supposed to talk about it. I'm supposed to be about it. That's what they were doing. They were being about it. That was not, they were playing hard in that game.
Yeah, I would agree with Ramona. I think that this is a show of force. Is that they want to show off their arsenal here, and they did with Anthony Davis particularly. And I think it's important for the Lakers to kind of set that tone early, because it felt like last season at times, and Ramona, you and I talked about this a lot, right? Like, there was this kind of strange approach to the season. LeBron took a very similar tack to what he did in the Eastern Conference, and he noticed very quickly with the group he was surrounded by that probably wasn't the right tack to take to kind of roll into the season. It looks like he's ready to go right out of the gate.
Look, he's got a guy who's on his level. He's got a running mate now. What are you going to call him? Batman or Robin? Whatever this duo is here, I think AD's going to probably outscore him this year just based on the way LeBron was setting him up and everybody was setting him up. But this is a scary duo, and LeBron was... He had a young group. Like, he couldn't necessarily play with them, coach them, push them the way that he and Anthony Davis already have that level and that basis.
Well, Janae, if you remember, LeBron said last year when asked about how he bonded with his teammates, he said, well, you know, my kids like some of the same things they like, so
yeah.
I can understand where they come from in this regard.
This is a little different, though, because when you have AD, it's not about, like, those kids idolize AD, too.
Yeah.
So, like, it's a respect factor. You alluded to it. AD could be probably statistically the best player on the Lakers, but the fact that LeBron can also give you assists, and then defensively you'll have Danny Green, and then knocking down like this team, if they play to their potential, and more importantly, if they play defense, they will be a powerhouse.
Yeah, the defense to me is the part I want to see what it looks like in the regular season, because you can be all gung-ho and want to play defense and say you want to play defense, but at the end of the day, you have to be able to execute and be willing to do that. And LeBron has made a business decision over the years, one I agree with, to not necessarily go all out early on, particularly on that side of the floor, because he wants to be ready for when it matters the most. Like, I get it.
Like, you see that TV pro right there? She just looked at the camera and said, if they play defense.
It's like a subliminal. It's a subliminal.
No, it's true, though. It is true.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.